Hey there, welcome back to our channel. In this video, we are gonna dive into how to build a vendor management portal inside of Softr. Let's get started. So first and foremost, we actually have a custom template for this at softr.io. And as always, you can either preview the template to take a look at everything, where there's gonna be two different user groups that allow you to explore it. So as you can see in this one, there is a vendor and an employee level user group. Now within this, we also can just press use template, and after pressing use and adding it to our respective system, we can copy the base to our Airtable account and then see the different data that we have within here. So first we have users. So right here we can see we have one vendor and one employee. The vendors themselves are right here, showcasing what their websites are, their country, what kind of category, and then a couple other pieces of metadata like the start date, end date, address, and then their status. In the product section, we have the products that are delivered by those vendors. As you can see here, they're all connected to the various vendors that you saw on that last tab. And then in the order section, we have the orders that are being fulfilled based off of the different products. So, right, wood offers drawers is what this order is related to. And this formula is essentially taking the name of the product with an ID, and then you'll see that through all these, this is how the order numbers are figured out. It showcases the created date and time, who requested it user-wise, and then moving into the template itself, let's take a look at how this would look from a vendor standpoint. So the vendors have the ability to see open order requests. So say I was a vendor trying to provide these, you'd see what the different items are available to be inputted. Then I could click on this. I could update this order, change the quantity for it. But this is essentially the details of this white office chair order. I see the price, quantity, and then the description of the product along with the delivery date and who has requested this. And this is the exact same for any of the different orders that you'd have within here. You can go to the See All Orders page in this homepage, and then when I press See All Orders, it'll like bring you down to this, and you'll notice that the new order or shipped label is showcased. Now that is based off the status within the Airtable. So if I wanted to, I can click into any of these, and then we'll see some of the metadata of that as well. So example, the delivery date, final price, and who is the requester. And now in the My Products page, what this is showing is the different products that are offered by me as this vendor. So for example, if we go to this right here, you can see all the different vendor products within this section. But if we wanted to see my products, I could then go to this vendor products page, which would show my products. Now, the way that this functions is that it is conditionally filtered. So the vendor's email, if they're logged in, it showcases logged in user's email. Now, the reason that this is the case is because only the vendors can see this. And when it comes to my products and this vendor products page, the settings have it so that the user group vendor is allowed to see this page, but the other user, the employee, is not. But if I wanted to get more info on any of these as a vendor, I would just go into, for example, this sofa, had a nice description, the category, and the number. And I also can go and open more and see the rest of the ones that I provide. So this is essentially the catalog of what you provide, and then the all orders page is what is actually being ordered from your stuff. And then if you wanted to add a new product, there is a form here that would allow you to put the name, as you can see, the description, the price, and then the category, and essentially fill in this view right here with an image if you would like as well. And the way that this form works is that it maps to the data source for your Airtable base now. So it would go into that product table inside of Airtable or Google Sheets. And then it's gonna map to the different fields like product name, description, category, price, the image. And then the last thing is, it's going to make sure that it maps to the vendor that is logged in, right? So the logged in user's vendor ID needs to be what's put in here, because if it's not, then essentially it could go to anybody. But since you are logged in as that vendor, when you're using the template, it will then map and go right into this section. Now let's take a look at this from an employee perspective. The employees are able to essentially see the different vendors that exist. So rather than when you're logged in as the vendor, you should only be able to see yours. They can see all of the different vendors that are around. So for example, Beyond Inc., if I click on this, you can see that the status is that they're currently stopped working. The rating wasn't awesome. The category was office supplies. And if we want to go in and see some more details, we can open the vendor details page to get all of the different ratings to see how this got to 2 out of 5. We could update the vendor record, and that can be edited in the vendor details page here. And essentially what you're able to do is create the action button that would update the following fields. So like all the stuff that you're seeing above, and especially what could be important is the status if they come back after they're not working anymore. Now, the vendor products are going to showcase here, very similarly to what you saw in the My Vendor page. This is just categorized into whatever vendor you have clicked into in the template. And then if you wanted to add a new product, very similarly, you can do it just like you had done with the form on the other page as the vendor side of it. And then here we have the ability to see different products specifically, filter them based off office supplies or food and beverage. Very simple and easy to do process. Gotta love some good kombucha. Then we also have the option for adding a vendor here. Now this will just send us to a form that allows us to add a specific vendor to this system. As an employee, this is a very important thing for you to do in the system so that you can get them in there, because vendors aren't gonna necessarily add themselves here. And very similarly, you'll notice that it just maps to all of the different items within the vendor table here, or sheet if you're using Google Sheets. And then there's a hidden field, which the value should be not started, because when you're making a new one, it really hasn't started, so that would make sense. You can adjust or get rid of any of these fields as you create a new field inside of here. You can always add an additional field or remove any other ones that aren't needed. Like for example, we could have a field for created by, so that we'd know like, oh, who's the logged in user that added this to the system? I wanna know. And if you want to change any of the filtering options within any of this system, you totally can. Like for example, this one is filtered to status, but at the top, if we wanted to, we could totally add any different filters that we'd want with the different options that you'd see here. Or you can change the search bar to not only look by product, but also the order ID, the vendor, or the name from the user requested as well, if that makes sense for you. There's always a myriad of different options and ways that you can update your systems and utilize amazing templates that we have here at Softr. If you're looking for other awesome templates, we have a myriad of different videos on them here on Softr's YouTube channel. So make sure to check out the rest of our content, like, subscribe, and check out this video on how to improve your skills using Softr even more.